Welcome. This is part two of the BensCarts.com and LearnHotDogs.com free training series. Part two is this for you. It's not for everyone, so let's run through some of the pros and cons of the hot dog cart business. First, it is still work. Yes, I said work. It's not like digging ditches, but it's harder than being a lottery winner. It's harder than most of those sites that are out there claim it to be. You will be your own boss. So if you're not self-motivated and able to push yourself off the couch, this ain't for you. If watching Oprah or some other mind-numbing show on TV is more important than making a great living, then it's probably not for you either. You must be able to self-direct. You will be the CEO, the president, and chairman of the board of your very own hot dog cart business. Don't be discouraged. The pros outweigh the cons by a mile or 10. So stand by and we'll cover those soon. If you have always worked for someone else, worked indoors, or have always had someone else control your income, then this will be much different. This is not an all-male club either. My young teen daughters can run a cart as good as me. In fact, female operators tend to do better, and even without a bikini on. Along with being your own boss and controlling your own income comes a few obstacles. You'll need insurance, licenses, food safety training, but all these are a one-time deal. Once out of the way, you'll be unstoppable. In some states, you can have all that done in just a few days. You'll have inventory, prep work, cleanup, and you'll have to find a commissary and the location. These are simply a part of the business and part of the reason everybody isn't a vendor, which is good, right? Less competition. Weather can also limit you. Even if you get a stand-in cart, if the weather is bad, the odds are your customers won't be out in front. I now look at rainy days as a little gift. As if Mother Nature said, "Hey Ben, you've been working real hard. Take the day off, catch up on those Miss Jerry Springer reruns, and relax a bit." I must say I do take advantage of those days when they come. What if you find out that the city restricts vendors? Oh crap, right? Well, no. I will show you how to overcome about any obstacle a little bit later. So don't give up before you even get started. None of these hyped up hot dog vendor websites that are just out there to sell you stuff will share with you about the hours spent prepping, doing cleanup, and they do still exist. I've learned some tricks about these and ways to make it easier. I just want you to have all the facts. Then you can make an educated decision as to whether this business is for you. See, I've just helped some of you from spending money and having an expensive dust collector sitting out in your garage. That's it. That's all the bad, and I'm not even sweating yet. Join me over on part three for the pros, the good stuff, and learn why hot dogs save my life.